Hey everybody, Norm from Tested here, and we got a special preview for you today. Recently, I was able to meet with Lenovo, who's working on a next generation computer, laptop. They don't even know what to call it, but it's the first device I've seen at this size that has a foldable display. Yeah, foldable displays are gonna become a thing, and we've already seen them on phones like the Samsung Galaxy Fold, but also I bet in the next year or two, a lot of laptop or tablet type devices will also have foldable displays. So I went over to meet with Lenovo and chatted with Mike from their team to learn about this new product. Let's go take a look. All right, everyone. I'm here with Michael from Lenovo on the ThinkPad team and super excited because this is our first chance to look at this laptop, tablet. I'm not even sure what to call it. Do you guys even have a name for it yet?
Well, it's the world's first foldable PC. It's a ThinkPad. It's part of the X1 family, but we don't have a name for it right now.
Well, let's talk about its design. Maybe we'll come up with a name as we get through this. But immediately, in this current state right now, it's folded, and we can see it has a big folding display. So I imagine the design of this product originated around the idea of wanting to create a computer with this type of display.
Yes.
Tell me about the display first. Who makes it, and what are its dimensions and specs?
Okay, so it's a 13.3-inch OLED display. It's made by LG Display. It's 2K in resolution. It's a 13.3, as I mentioned, in screen size. In the two displays is basically a 9.6 inch. And obviously it folds.
And what's interesting to me is that it is a 4:3 aspect ratio.
Yes,
it is. Which is not traditional because your laptops are all 16:9. Imagine that's because when you fold it, then you get something that's more usable.
Yes, you can use it in basically any orientation. So, you know, in this orientation, you get a nice big 13.3. You can also use it in this orientation. And again, it's still very usable. It's not sort of letterboxed. So you get a lot of content, as you can see from this image. There's even room at the bottom for more content. So very, very useful in productivity and that kind of thing.
I see it's running Windows. It's like a ThinkPad, an x86 system. So Michael, in terms of what's inside, is it running Intel? Is it equivalent to what you'd find in like a ThinkPad?
It will be running an Intel CPU. And obviously being the X1, it will have a compute power that you can do all your daily normal activities on it. Obviously if you want to run massive spreadsheets, CAD work, this is not a device for that, right? We have a full line of other products to do that. So the idea of this machine is, of course, it's very compact, it's very small, it closes up, it's very portable, so very battery efficient, and you can get most of what you need to do done on this machine.
Now, I do want to get back to the screen, but in terms of being a laptop, you're designing it presumably like a laptop, a top half and a bottom half. Is that how you think of where the components are distributed in the battery as well?
Yes. So the weight is on the bottom right here so that you can actually use it like this in this mode. If you're stuck on a bus or something like that, you can whip it out and do some email or shopping or media, that kind of thing.
And that's where the battery is.
That's where the battery would be.
Chipset would be
up on the top.
On the top part.
Lighter type, yeah.
Right, and that's about a footprint about 9.7 inch. A little more than that would include the bezel.
About a 9.6 inch, yeah. Bottom, top half and bottom half.
And then, of course, the hinge that marries those. We've seen a lot of foldable displays out in the market right now on smartphones. Some have not performed as well as others. Mm-hmm. What considerations have you done to make this work as something that's going to be folded over again and something that will be usable completely flat and also at any angle?
Well, we've been working on this for quite a long time, and one of the key components is the hinge. And as you know, we're very good at hinges, right, with all our other yoga products and things like that. But getting the right trajectory of the hinge so that you don't put any stresses on the screen is very, very important. So that when you do bend it, there is no...
That freaks me out.
Yeah, there is no stress on the screen. So that when it is open, you can see that basically there's no crease in the middle, right?
So when it folds, it doesn't do a full crease.
No, it doesn't.
There's a little bit of a radius.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And that's intentional.
That's intentional, yes. So that you don't, that it'll last for a long, long time and it won't introduce any increasing like you've seen on some other products.
Is that something that's on the recommendation of your display partner and the testing they've done on display, or something that you guys have thought about and put in and
yeah, we've worked in conjunction with LG Display on this product, so it's a full partnership with those guys, yeah.
Well, let's talk about also the form factor, right? There's a little bit of a bezel. The different ways you use it, obviously, right now, you have, it's in a very traditional tablet use case. Running Windows, of course, touchscreen Windows.
Yes.
There's no keyboard attached, so input-wise, you have touch and the pen.
Yes, and there will be a physical keyboard available with it, which I can show you in a minute. But yes, it's touch, very obviously it's touch. You know, you can use it in this mode with the on-screen keyboard when it appears. Mm. You can quickly take the pen out. With the two windows, you can take notes on the bottom while you're watching a video or something like that on the top half or in a meeting, that kind of thing.
How does Windows see this device when you fold it? Does it see it as one display or does it see it as two displays where if you like maximize a window, it's only
it's one display.
One display.
Yes.
So you would stretch your window to the top half, or if you want it to go around the curve, you can stretch it beyond that.
Yes, you can. Yes, you know, and we've again, it's a will be a Windows-based system, and we've been working with Microsoft to create an experience that you know you'd expect with a device like this.
And that goes into the on-screen keyboard and all the ways it recognizes what orientation you guys, like you said, have experienced with the yoga. In terms of recognizing that.
Right.
Is that one of the places where this started with the yoga and you realizing that people wanted to use their laptops in different ways as media display devices, and this goes kind of beyond that?
Yeah, I think you know, there's a room for a device like this in that it becomes so small that I want to take it places. I wouldn't necessarily take a traditional laptop because they are larger. This obviously is very, very small. It's like a size of a folio, right? So something that people are very, very used to in a form factor. But it's something small that goes to something big, right? And this is place, well, I would take this to places I may not necessarily take my laptop. So for instance, lunch, right? I could take it to lunch and then do other, like check up on social media or do some shopping, that kind of thing. And it's better the, you obviously get a better experience with a bigger screen than you may with a cell phone, right?
Mm-hmm.
And also, you know, where's it? You know, I don't need to be holding the phone all the time, right? I can look at stuff, I can eat, and I can do more things because it also stands on its own.
Since you're using a full Intel chipset, I assume you have a lot of the same I/O as traditional laptops. Can you talk about what are the inputs you're going to get and outputs?
So it'll have two USB-C device interfaces on it. So that'll allow you to dock, and you can dock in, you know, this mode, right, here, or if I'm in this mode, again, you'll be able to dock on the lower left as well.
Mm.
So we've accounted for that.
And it charges over that same port as well?
Yes, charges, yeah.
And expandability in terms of micro SD or SD?
No, there's no expandability. You know, this will be an always-on, always-connected device, so it will support, you know, WAN, so access to the cloud will always be there. So, you know, cloud storage, obviously you'll have plenty of storage as well, but you know, you can augment that with cloud storage as well.
You know, this is just a prototype, but presumably you have all your design decisions already done. You know what chipset you're going to use, you know your input's going to be, you know, the screen size. When you went about designing this, was there a cap to the weight, and also in terms of the heat that you wanted to get from this as well?
Yeah, weight was very important, that we were trying to reach a weight that it didn't really seem too heavy, right? We want it to be very mobile, and of course if you get to a certain weight, then it's going to be too heavy. We haven't finalized the weight on that. We're still working through a few things.
Any ballpark range?
Well, we definitely under 2 pounds, I think, is our goal. But again, you know, we still have some development to go on there.
Mm-hmm. The active cooling, of course, if you're running a full,
yes,
full Intel processor.
Yeah.
Very cool. Yeah. How close is this then to being done? It's something that you guys are showing off this year. You know, when will foldable screen computers become a thing?
The launch window is basically the first half of next year. We haven't finalized when we're actually going to launch it or it will be available, but first half is the target, yeah.
I know you guys don't have a name yet, and maybe an obvious name is something like the Fold, but it's not something you're necessarily considering, so I'm really curious out there what people think it should be called, but this is a fascinating
name. Yeah, we'll take suggestions.
Yeah, thank you so much, Michael.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, so there are many more questions about this product that we just don't know yet. First of all, they've been working on it for about 3 years in partnership with LG, who's making that display, and they really wanted to reinforce that it was LG as their display partner because the different type of foldable OLED that's on the Samsung phone. It doesn't have that removable film layer that people saw in the Galaxy Folds that then made them not really usable. Also, a big difference between this device and the foldable phones we've seen is that it doesn't fold completely flat. There's a little bit of a curve or a radius at the end, so it's less pressure on that hinge. The hinge itself is also interesting. Lenovo has been known to make some pretty good hinges on their ThinkPads or Lenovo Yoga laptops, which I liked in the past. And the hinge here, while we couldn't get a direct camera look at it, they're calling it a torque hinge. And for my use with it, it held pretty rigid at about every angle to flat that we could get it to. It doesn't go past flat. The display doesn't fold backwards. But from closed to open, at any one of those angles, it held pretty sturdily. Now, the display itself, when it's flat, it read as a seamless display. It looked good. It's OLED. It's bright. The viewing angles are okay, not the best I've seen from other OLED panels. But what's interesting is when you fold it, it does start looking a little weird. It's really trippy. My brain says, don't fold it. Don't fold it. You don't want to do this. And yet, you can. I'm folding it in half. And when I'm folding it and looking right down the center, right between where the fold is, the image quality, the light quality, the panel quality in the center and the edges are slightly different. It's a continuous image, but the quality of image is slightly different. I don't know if it's because it's different viewing angles, obviously, from down here and off to the sides, but it's darker on the sides and brighter in the center. And you can see I tried putting a pen and drawing between it, and as I'm folding it, it's purely a seamless device. On the inside, we also don't know exactly what they're going to be running. They did confirm Intel x86, probably a next-gen unannounced Intel processor. On the mobile side, Intel has H series, U series, Y series, definitely not H series. So it's the difference between the U series and the Y series. My gut says it's going to probably be a Y series device, but I'd love to be proven wrong. That does mean probably fewer cores and slower clock speeds. Mike said that this is not going to be a heavy workhorse, but it'd be more for like content consuming and the demos they had with reading, with video viewing, illustrated that as well. Two inputs with USB-C and no expandability. So don't know how much you're gonna be able to put in this device. It will be one of those always on connected devices. So expect to use cloud storage. And then finally, usability. Does the world need a foldable laptop, tablet, computer like this? And I think there's a case to be made for this, right? I carry an iPad Pro, which I love to travel with because it's compact, but there are places I wouldn't take it. I wouldn't take it necessarily out for lunch because even though it's thin and light, it is a big footprint. The footprint here, when it's folded in half at 9.6, 9.7 inches, is pretty small. That's really easy to throw in a backpack. And then unfolded at 13.3 inches, that's actually a really nice canvas for, you know, for web browsing, for sketching and drawing using their pen. It really will go down to how the software will take advantage of it. Now, they couldn't say it runs exactly Windows 10, although it is x86, so there's a lot of time between now and the first half of next year. Who knows what version of Windows might be out that this could run on, but it's gonna run full applications, and I'm excited for that opportunity as well. They didn't say whether it would have a kickstand or not, but they did say that it would be able to be used propped up. So whether that's with a dock, I think it would make a lot of sense for this to have a kickstand. But I think pen input, touch input, and then probably keyboard input as a third use case for this will probably make the most sense for a device like this. There's just so much unknown about this. It didn't weigh too much. They're aiming for under 2 pounds. I think if it's in that 1.5 pound, 1.6 pound range, that could be pretty compelling. but it is our first glimpse at a product in this category. We've been used to tablets for 10 years now and laptops for far longer than that. And we've had lots of promises for a device to kind of bridge the two in a really compact form factor. You remember back in 2009, there were rumors that Microsoft was going to make a device called the Courier that was basically, you know, a laptop with two screens. Well, this has the potential to fulfill the promise of the Courier, except it actually being one screen. I wouldn't be surprised if in the next 2 years, 3 years, we're gonna see a lot of laptops, tablets, whatever you wanna call them, convertibles that use foldable OLED screens. And we'll have more on that when those actually come out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.